Altair is a declarative statistical visualization library for Python. Its concise syntax can produce an impressive number of beautiful interactive visualizations. One interesting aspect of Altair is it doesn't actually render any visualizations. Let me explain. Consider this line from the documentation. Altair provides a Python API for generating validated Vega-Lite specifications. In other words, what Altair actually does is produce JSON. What you do as a user is specify what you want to be visualized and pass the specification to the browser or another front-end to be rendered. The specification, or spec for short, is essentially a high-level description of the visualization. Altair and Vega-Lite share a mostly complete one-to-one mapping. In fact, most of the code base for Altair was generated programmatically from the Vega-Lite schema. So what is this JSON file then? JSON isn't even a programming language. Turning to the Vega-Lite documentation for some answers. Vega-Lite is a high-level grammar of interactive graphics. It provides a concise JSON syntax for rapidly generating visualizations to support analysis. This is where we start to go down the rabbit hole, but bear with me. I think some historical context helps to clear things up. In 1999, Leland Wilkinson published a book titled The Grammar of Graphics, in which he outlines, in great detail, the grammatical structure of a wide range of statistical visualizations. Wilkinson's work was very influential, and many tools were built around the idea of visualization grammars. One popular example is the ggplot2 library for R. Visualization grammars are a fascinating subject, which deserve a video of their own. So back to the story. Altair produces a Vega-Lite specification, which is a JSON file describing the visualization using a high-level visualization grammar. It is considered high-level because some useful defaults are assumed. For instance, Vega-Lite will automatically produce appropriate scales and legends rather than you having to specify every component of your visualization. Understanding the visualization grammar is critical in knowing what Vega-Lite, and therefore Altair, is capable of visualizing. The Vega-Lite project is more than just a specification schema. Vega-Lite specs are compiled into a more detailed Vega spec before being rendered. The Vega-Lite compiler is what allows the high-level JSON spec to be so expressive. Vega specs are much more detailed. They are still JSON files, but some of the high-level Vega constructs aren't provided. You have to specify every component of the visualization. The Vega specs are actually much closer to Wilkinson's original detailed visualization grammar. The benefit of having such a detailed description is that it enables more flexibility and customization. Now from the Vega docs. Each Vega specification defines a reusable, shareable chart component. In essence, Vega provides a file format for saving and sharing visualization designs. The Vega specification is the grammatical foundations of Vega-Lite and Altair. Again, the Vega project is more than just a specification. The Vega runtime parses the JSON and renders the associated visual elements in the browser using powerful libraries such as D3. A detailed description of D3 is beyond the scope of this video, but it is one of the most popular tools for creating visualizations on the web. Now to bring it all together. Altair is a Python library that outputs Vega-Lite specifications. Vega-Lite is a high-level visualization grammar. The Vega-Lite spec is compiled into a more verbose Vega specification, which completely describes the visualization in terms of its visual elements. The Vega spec is then rendered in the browser using JavaScript libraries such as D3. There's a lot going on behind the scenes, but I think having a better understanding of the process makes Altair a little easier to use. I hope this video helps orient new Altair users, as well as explain many of the tools on which Altair depends. Links are in the description to the Altair, Vega-Lite, and Vega documentation, as well as a few wonderful tutorials. Dive in, make some plots, and have some fun.